Coming up,
we didn't have any rainfall that grew any grass. And so what do you do on a cattle ranch when you don't have any grass?
You have to deal not just with 1 year of drought, but maybe 2 or even 3 years of below average rainfall. And that can put people out of business really quickly.
Hear the story of how one insurance company supports ranching families when a lack of rain threatens their livelihood. Next on The American Rancher. Hello, I'm Justin McKee, and welcome to The American Rancher. In the 2018 Farm Bill, the federal government expanded the risk management options for farmers and ranchers. One of those provisions is the USDA's Pasture, Rangeland, Forage Insurance Program that is available through private insurance companies such as CKP Insurance in Boca Raton, Florida. This innovative but straightforward program is designed to give ranchers the ability to buy insurance protection for losses due to lack of rainfall. One of the beneficiaries of CKP's PRF insurance is Menges Ranch, just outside of Safford, Arizona.
We have 600 to 800 head of mother cows. We have registered Angus bulls on a commercial Angus herd. And we market our calves in the spring. A lot of the time, they're sold on the Superior Livestock. I was raised on a cattle ranch about an hour from the ranch. I've been managing this ranch for 11 years, but I just purchased half of the ranch last year. And so I'm a 50-50 partner on the ranch. So I'm still fairly new to this business, although I feel old. But I think that there's no better business when it comes to your personal freedom and your interaction with the environment and livestock. We're raising cattle in one of the most natural ways possible. We're raising them on the rangeland with plenty of space, and I get to see country that most people pay a lot of money to see. I spend about 150 days a year on the back of a horse, and so I'm constantly checking cattle, gathering cattle. I enjoy my job because I like the pasture, horse, cattle combination. If you remove one of those, then it's not a ranch, in my opinion. We ranch along the Gila River, and there are tributaries to the Gila River, the San Francisco River and Bonita Creek, and we're on both of those also. All along these riparian areas, as they're called, there were homesteads, and these homesteads sort of established agriculture in this region. And we're some of the only people left who are continuing to practice agriculture on these riparian areas. It's a very difficult place to ranch. Throughout Arizona, it's 60 to 100 acres per cow. So you're talking about 10 to 20,000 acre pastures. My neighbor has a 20,000 acre pasture that he has to gather. So when you experience drought, it creates a variety of challenges. It's much more difficult to gather those pastures. Those cattle are all the way on the edges of the pasture, and try putting supplement out for 200 head on 20,000 acres. That's a challenge. You know, we're no stranger to drought. We've experienced drought growing up. I remember 2003, 2004, and we had to sell a lot of cattle then. Thankfully, we're in an area that has some browse, which is mesquite and whitethorn, and they put out beans, and so the cattle are able to forage on those beans. In the 50s and 60s, when there was a drought, the ranchers would burn all of the spines off of prickly pear cacti, and the cattle would eat those. And so that's why we have so much cacti around. And the cactus is like your last resort in terms of forage, but some cows will resort to that. The water is a main issue on the ranch, and I spend a lot of time checking waters. We have over 100 miles of pipeline on this ranch. 100% of the water that the cows drink was brought to them by solar power. And so the water was brought to the cows with zero emissions, and I don't think you or I could say that the water we drink was brought to us with zero emissions, but if our cows could talk, they would say that.
I have a product called RanchBot, and it's a water monitoring system that goes into storage tanks, and it has saved me quite a bit of time going and checking tanks. It's probably cut my time in half. Like, I have a storage tank that's a couple hours from my house. I've figured that it saved me about $1,200 a year, because that's I was spending about $2,400 just to go and check one tank.
Normally about 2 out of every 10 years where we experience extreme drought, and this is one of the years. We're supposed to get around 12 inches a year. We've had less than 4 this year. The most of that occurred in the spring, so it's been a long time since it really rained here. I believe that this is the worst year that I've experienced, and I've been here 11 years. Managing this ranch full time. This means that we're weaning calves earlier. It means that we're selling a lot more cows. We're not selling our entire cow herd, because it takes a long time for these cows to acclimate. So if you sell your cow herd and buy some back, they won't be adjusted to the ranch. So we have to wean calves and focus on the cows. The cows are what we're responsible for. That's our first priority. And so it's been a real struggle to try to manage around drought this year for us. There are easier ways to make a living, but I don't think I'd prefer them. I wouldn't do it any other way.
After the break.
We didn't have any rainfall that grew any grass. And so what do you do on a cattle ranch when you don't have any grass?
Hear why PRF insurance from CKP is an important tool in Ben's drought mitigation plan when the American Rancher continues. Welcome back. Ben Menges operates Menges Ranch in Safford, Arizona. Ranching in southeastern Arizona is tough, and margins can be thin on good years. Pile on the challenges of a drought, and you have a recipe for baking under the sun of hard times.
In Arizona, we rely on a monsoon season in June and July and through August. Sometimes it goes into September, but not often. And we didn't experience a monsoon season this year that is anything that would benefit us. So we didn't have any rainfall that grew any grass. And so what do you do on a cattle ranch when you don't have any grass? That presents a variety of obstacles that we're trying to overcome right now, but thankfully we have a few options. Some of those options are sending cattle to the feedlot, purchasing hay, and you know, the cost of hay is low this year, and so that's good for us. And the price of cattle is also high, so if we're encouraged to send them to the feedlot, we can grow them, and the cost of gain isn't that much because feed is low. And the cattle are going to perform well when it comes time to sell them. One of the options we have is CKP's PRF insurance. This is a program that allows you to select intervals for rainfall. And if it doesn't rain, or if it's below average in these intervals, then you will get a payment. And it's not every year that you get a payment, so it's, you know, it's not just a handout.
The Pasture, Range, and Forage program has been a very popular product, which has helped producers mitigate the impacts of reduced precipitation. Very simple applications. It's federal crop insurance, so depending, the only difference you have is from ourselves or anybody else or the agents. And I think we've got a great team. We work with great carriers. Generally takes somewhere in the neighborhood of about an hour in terms of sitting down, showing a producer their ground, it's kind of walking through and explaining the product.
So I meet with my CKP agent in September or October, and we sit down with a plan on the best intervals, the most crucial intervals to us to select, and we'll select them. And if there's above average rainfall, we won't get a payment. And if there's below, then we will. And that's money that is used to benefit our cow herd. We've sent cattle to the feedlot with this program. We've purchased quite a bit of feed, and especially on years like this, we'll use it not only for feed, but for added labor to put this feed out, for the cost of bringing cattle in, for fuel. You know, the type of dollars that are available through PRF are dollars that keep the American cattleman in business. And I think that PRF is a program that is the federal government saying, we understand how difficult it is to deal with drought, and we want to help you out. CKP has data on how often these intervals have paid out, and that has made the process fairly easy for me. I don't select intervals that are fewer than 7 or 8 times out of the year. And so there's a high percentage of payout for the grids that I ranch in.
I live on a cow-calf operation where I have been for the last 37 years. My children are fifth generation ranchers, and we run crossbred cattle in the high desert areas of southeastern Arizona. One thing about ranching in Arizona is you know drought. You know how to continue a production and be viable through a lack of rainfall all the way to you don't get rain for 6-8 months. So you have to be very flexible, very nimble, and very creative. You have to deal not just with 1 year of drought, but maybe 2 or even 3 years of below average rainfall, and that can put people out of business really quickly. So I believe in this program because I've seen it on our ranch, what we're able to do. When you receive below average rainfall, you get a benefit. Pays off your premium first, but the rest of that money can be used for whatever you would like. So that helps you get through a drought. You can relax a little bit because you know you're covered. What you can't control is the weather. If you can control your income to a certain extent by knowing you're going to get a benefit, it makes ranching much less stressful knowing what you can do. The best thing about Pasture Rangeland Forage, you are in control of this program. You can set your premium by how many acres you choose to insure. It really takes the stress off.
This product, since it is based on the area that you're in, it can definitely be catered regardless of the part of the country you're in. You know, you could be in the Eastern Corn Belt, you could be in the Pacific Northwest or the South Central United States.
Every rancher is different, every zone or region is different. So one person in Oklahoma might not be the same as the person in Texas or even in Nevada.
This program has been able to help multiple people throughout Central California due to the duration of our droughts that we've had. I have firsthand seen how this helps the producers by themselves have to supplement feed because we're not getting the rainfall that we need to grow grazing grass. And this program helps them immensely with financial aid.
Without CKP's PRF insurance, we would have had to sell a lot more cattle off of this ranch, and we wouldn't have survived the drought in previous years. And I know that they're a main factor, the PRF insurance is a main factor in how we're going to survive this year.
Up next,
CKP gives back to the ranching community more than any other agency that I've seen in Arizona.
Hear why CKP Insurance is much more than a source for risk mitigation insurance. That's after the break. Keep it right here. Welcome back to the American Rancher. CKP founders Kevin Rader and Chuck Hemphill have been in the insurance business since the early 1990s. And in 2010, they began to focus entirely on the needs of American agriculture producers. Today, the company provides insurance services and civic support for producers and their families throughout the lower 48 states. And that includes experience working with tribal governments and assisting with legislation and agriculture infrastructure.
Of course, we're doing construction insurance, and when it collapsed, we were doing anything we could. And somebody needed to insure Palm Tree Farm in South Florida. And the rep who was teaching us the classes to insure palm trees said there's this really good insurance program that no one has really tried to sell too much of. And my partner and I hit the road and started driving around states and finding people that could use the product of both PRF and LRP. And so it grew exponentially every year. It doubled, tripled, quadrupled. And we became one of, if not the largest writer of that type of insurance across the country.
Obviously, the biggest product has been the Pasture, Range, and Forage program. I work with livestock grazers and hay producers on both irrigated and non-irrigated ground. The other product, which has really come on fire in the last few years, the Livestock Risk Protection Program, that's a product that gives livestock producers, cow-calf feeders, and backgrounders the opportunity to use risk protection and protect themselves from downward movements in the market without a margin call. It's got that delayed premium being due at the end of the endorsement, so you can take advantage of the upticks in the market, take some protection out, and lock in some downside protection at very reasonable rates that'll give you a chance to sleep at night. The first time that I had thought about the Pasture, Range, and Forage program, or even the Livestock Risk Protection, I looked at this and I thought, well, this might work for me, and I'm a small producer. I run 100 cows. The Pasture, Range, and Forage program, you could literally have 10 acres. It's a great product for both irrigated and non-irrigated producers, ground that you own or lease. And on the livestock side of things, the flexibility that's been built into LRP gives you the ability to protect a single animal if you want it. So you don't have to think about a contract size protection. It might be 5 head. The other nice benefit with LRP, there's a great opportunity for beginning farmers and ranchers. So the big challenge that we have in our industry is trying to get young people in and make sure they can afford the cost of entry into the game. Those producers have the opportunity for their first 5 years to get an additional 10% premium subsidy.
CKP gives back to the ranching community more than any other PRF agency that I've seen in Arizona. I've seen them at every cattle growers event. I've seen them around the community at rodeos. They are always sponsoring something that I'm at, it seems like. And that's one of the reasons that I went with CKP.
The truth of the matter is anybody can do insurance and sell you something. But we wanted to make sure that we supported our customers in a way that was beneficial. And, you know, making money is great, but, you know, we kind of think of it, we want to be part of the family as well. So we've got a lot of different initiatives going. We're actually working on a scholarship program right now as a test one, but to kind of help ranching families continue and have their kids be able to go to ag school with some support from CKP. We like to do the grassroots 4-H stuff, very into that, you know. So any way we can give back to make sure that we're supporting our customers, because, you know, it's not just about us, it's about the team and about our customers doing better in the long run.
Chuck has done an amazing job working with the FSA office and the USDA on transitioning in some new legislature for our tribal accounts. A lot of those in the past may not have been eligible for PRF, and I know Chuck has worked very, very hard on getting those types of accounts approved by the USDA and the FSA office, and not only being eligible for programs, but how to make them successful when the funding comes through, and so that, you know, those resources are distributed into the right areas and it's being used for the right things. You know, second of all, with Kevin being a part of that, Kevin was a former state representative for the state of Florida. So he's been extremely influential in making policy changes, not only in the state of Florida, but nationally.
Hopefully, as an organization, we're not gonna be known for selling insurance, although that's what we do. We're gonna be known as a partner to help manage the risk and keep the rancher family lifestyle going well and sustainable for the future. That's more our goal than selling insurance. We have an office in Scottsdale. We have another office in New Mexico, as well as the corporate office in Florida. But we have agents in Florida, California, Washington, Utah, New Mexico, Arizona, a few. Probably gonna leave some out. In addition to that, really, we travel all over the country. I don't know how many miles that we all put on, but it's substantial. So we really try to go to where our customers need us.
More than just a business relationship, it becomes a personal relationship because we understand their struggles and are able to help them through it. It's been very rewarding and fulfilling for me.
If people have questions about pasture, range, and forage, livestock risk protection, reach out to us. I mean, I always have the phone with me. We're here to help. There's some great opportunities. Really excited about what the future is going to hold in terms of Superior and CKP, and I hope that's something that could be a benefit to the reps, the customer base, and it's going to be a win-win. The rising tide is going to be fabulous.
To find out more about CKP's pasture, rangeland, forage, and livestock risk protection services, log on to CKPinsurance.com. And to find out more about us, log on to our website, TheAmericanRancher.com, and follow us on Facebook and YouTube. I'm Justin McKee. For Pam Minnick and the entire American Rancher team, thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time.